Week 3 was pretty exciting. That long fasting before going to Adrenbrooks, which is a Cambridge hospital, was one of the medical studies that I went to. I only ever participated in one. They're very well paid but hard to get into. On Saturday we had a Jane Street challenge, which is kind of like a mini hackathon, just 12 hours. But instead of doing whatever you want, you need to trade on simulated stock exchange.
21st of October, beautiful morning. I'm going to Queen's College because, well, can I program well? No. Do I know how to use Amazon Web Services? No. Do I actually like being a part of a team? No. Am I gonna do a hackathon that uses web services and will have to be in a group of 6 or 4 other people? Yep. Even better than this, it is... Even better than this, it is organized by Jane Street, which is some trading organization, and all the finance firms earn so much, so they're pouring a lot of money into this, so I'm expecting a lot of good food.
Update. Echo. It is actually going so well. We are trading on some fake simulated markets and analyzing like just server messages in JSON format. I'm so glad I can actually understand what's happening because I've actually done some Python over the summer in my internship. The people on my team are very nice. One guy is from the UK, another one is from Serbia. We have a lot of food, we have bean bags. It's all pretty chilled. It's 1 p.m. already and we started at around 11. Learning things about bonds and stocks, which is also great. So yeah, I think some hackathons are definitely more enjoyable than others.
Basically, I'm a trader now. Wrote an algorithm that was at first giving us like $100, let's say dollars per round, and now it's given us 5,000, and we were maybe like 17th group out of 26, and now we're 10th. It's still like we're in the top half, let's say. That's so impressive, honestly. That's my first hackathon where I'm actually happy, eaten a lot of pizza, a lot of drinks, and fruit as well. But overall, I just feel great.
Trading is happening there, and we are second. So I probably look absolutely terrible, but I don't care. It's done now. I am a very, very happy person today. We unfortunately came second, but it didn't matter. The first prize was £511, which is a lot, but what I got was this. Bananas will probably go to my vegan friend, because she's the best, and will probably make me more banana bread, and a vegetarian burger, and some fruit. This will probably go to my I can eat anything friend. Water is life, so that's for me. Fizzy drinks, probably not. And some t-shirts, one for my size, some others for, I don't know, whoever really wants them. So as you can see, I am an amazing friend, just kind of putting it out there. If anyone wants to befriend me. The number of career fairs you can go to in the first term is so big. The first one was by QS, and here is Jane Street that organized the challenge. So what I love about Cambridge is all the careers fairs. Another day, another bag of goodies. Let's see what we have. So even though I feel guilty for wanting all the freebies, I do take the leaflets to make it seem like I'm actually interested in whatever that was. Software always gives a lot of nice jelly beans. A lot of companies are giving power banks and adapters. Some more power banks. Some actually give pencils. And of course, there's one even yo-yo and a mini watch. T-shirts, my favorite. This one is a funny thing to put your phone in and have it as a loudspeaker.
There's one room there, one room there, and some more there. There are hundreds of companies. companies finally started giving good freebies. I got a fidget spinner, I got bike lights. There were 64 companies today. There are 63 tomorrow, completely different ones, and a lot of freebies yet again.
What does today bring? I stopped going for pens and notebooks because, you know, I have that many and I still have notebooks and I'm not even using them because, like, come on, we all have laptops. But there are still some freebies that are worth having. Okay, that might not have been a good decision. Let's see. There's a lens for the phone, so you clip it and I guess your pictures become kind of funny. A cup and a sanitizer. Woohoo! So I think that's a pretty impressive haul. Second day and I sadly just have one small bag because I didn't have time. Don't want any more stuff. Also, I wanted to mention we don't have owls, sadly, like in Hogwarts, but we do have our pigeonholes, and I've never ordered anything, but now I needed some presents for my friend for her birthday, so that's very convenient that it comes directly to college. Now, off onto free stuff. More bike lights, thank you Jane Street. Then I finally have this cup. I don't even drink coffee, but I think I might because I might start because I'm so tired all the time. I know I said no notebooks, but this one looked cool. Started giving jelly beans, so there were two of those. More jelly beans. More. And Vodafone was the best. That's what I want to see. Self-service with a lot of sweets. Just love it. You could pour any type that you wanted, any amount that you wanted. Some water bottles. I'm not even sure what this is. Looks pretty weird to me. And yeah. Oh no. Okay. One more USB stick. It's probably time to do work instead of eating free food. Good time for dissertation update. I know I haven't told you anything about it yet. But basically I have a robot. It's of course just in simulation for now. But looking good. Look at it. And I'm supposed to make it move, and I couldn't even do that, to be honest, for like maybe days and days. But now I have something, and let's see. Oops. Ubuntu is nice, but then all of this is kind of annoying. I prefer Mac. Okay, so now if I press these buttons, it's supposed to move at least a little bit. Oh, hello, how about you go? Oh, that's sad. Doesn't want to go. Let's see. Debugging time.